This moment in human history, this moment that we're living through, this moment of upheaval, this moment of perceived chaos, is a bringing into the forefront of our awareness, everything that is unconscious within us, so that we can begin to unwind the dysfunction that we've created through repetitive habits, patterns, and behaviors that are rooted in fear, lack, and scarcity. My beloved friend, you're not broken. There's nothing wrong with you. It's time to simply take a look at how you're allowing life to flow through you and where you are not allowing for that flow. Financial issues, lack of flow. Love issues, lack of flow. Health issues, lack of flow. When you've got flow, you've got glow. It's how it works. And as the Sultan of Glow, you're in the right place. I am so happy that you are here. If you are new to meditation, welcome. Not only are you going to discover inner peace, but by the time we're done with you, you're going to sparkle. Just imagine, right? How many people in your life right now could just use a hug? How many people? How many people in your life right now could just use a hug? Every single human being. Why? Because they are in the fundamental rejection and denial of themselves. Of themselves. They're denying themselves at the level of the body, at the level of the mind, and at the level of their feelings. You know, we're chasing this perception and this false notion of perception, and we're missing the point that perfection is unfolding right in front of us every moment. Every moment. Every moment. The perfection is unfolding in front of us in every moment. And so anyway, I love you all. Thanks for letting me share. And again, it's not easy. But don't invalidate yourself. Don't invalidate your journey. It's, and actually, the more you turn and face who you are, and the more you embrace who you are, the easier it becomes. Because there's nothing wrong with you. So at some point, we have to get to a place where we begin to be with what's happening inside of us. And here's where this is profound. Here's where this is profound. When we begin to turn our attention to what we've been running away from, we find liberation. We find authentic power, which is love. We find freedom. Okay? Like, I personally went into a self-imposed isolation for 6 months when I went to the ashram to live like a monk. I lived a very simple monastic life. Nobody talks. My roommate just meditated all the time. He was fantastic. People had a hard time with him meditating the whole time. I'm like, well, what else are you supposed to do in an ashram? When you're in an ashram, meditate the whole time. It's great to me. It's great for me. And in that self-imposed time of isolation, of having a break, okay, from this created self, because really, what is meditation? Meditation is the opportunity to have a pause from the created self, right? Meditation is time where you don't have to pretend. The rest of your life, that's why it feels so good. The rest of your life, you have to pretend, right? To find belonging, to fit in, to say the right things, to express the right opinions, which is becoming increasingly harder, right? God forbid you express an opinion that people around you don't like, right? So you're constantly performing. But when you're meditating, you're not performing, right? When you're meditating, you're getting in touch with what the inner reality of yourself is. We're all a part of this never-ending story, every single one of us. And today, I want to support you in moving out of that place of sadness, moving out of that place of stuckness. I want to support you in feeling like you're enough so that you can begin to reclaim your inner child and redream the dream of your life. I feel like it's so important now that you recognize that you are not powerless, that you are not hopeless, that you in some way, shape, or form are not a victim, that you have a choice in all of this, that you have not only a choice, man, we're counting on you. We're counting on you to keep the dream alive, to keep the dream alive. I'm counting on you. All of creation is counting on you to keep everything alive, to keep everything enlivened, to keep the energy alive, enlivened, and filled with possibility. And the end result of this time of uncertainty, not knowing everything that you're going through, right? Of everything you're going through, is that you get to redream the dream of your life. Or everything that's happening right now as a part of this never-ending story is that you get to redream the dream of your life. Redream the dream of that job. Redream the dream of that relationship. Redream the dream of the family or wanting to have a family. Redream the dream of where you live. Redream the dream of everything. It's all up to you. It's all up to you. And you have the power. So either you're loving or you're being distracted from loving. I just want to be loving. I'm not living in East London anymore. I'm not needing to, you know, protect myself. You know, I'm not about to get shot or stabbed. You know, it's like, come on, right? At some point, we have to let these things go. We have to let them go. We have to let them go. So it doesn't matter what anyone does with anything. Let them do it in the way they need to do it. 2020 is a trigger fest. Everybody's activated. You can't say anything without activating a wound in somebody. At that point, be responsible for the wounds that are being activated within you and be with them and be with them and be with them. And I have to tell you, like, my favorite thing to do now, instead of getting upset about everything, I sit in my garden and listen to Pavarotti, you know, with the squirrels and the chipmunks. So would you rather be upset at everything? Or would you rather be in awe of God's creation, listening to Pavarotti? Where's the choice? There's no choice. So, all right, I love you. Thanks for listening.